breaking news. Apple is said to plan a move from Intel to its own chips for use in its Mac computers. Once again, Apple is said to be planning a move from Intel to its own Mac chips.
It's been confirmed that this year's WWDC will bring something new to the table. Although it looks like there will be hardware as well, iMacs to be specific. If leaked information is accurate, we are about to witness one very important announcement. It's time for the transition that we were waiting for. Let's talk about Apple's next direction right after intro. Hi there and welcome to Digital Marketing's channel. My name is Marco and this is your weekly fix of tech news, leaks, rumors and opinions. Everything about Apple and their competitors. If you're fond of this type of content, please subscribe and don't forget to hit notification icon so you don't miss the next video. It's time, we all heard the rumors, it's been coming at us for the last couple of years. In order to understand this, let's go back in the past, when Cupertino giant just started building computers. At that time, Apple was using 8-bit microprocessor, something that was developed by Motorola former employees. Eventually, Apple did go with Motorola 68K series back in the days of Lisa project. What is interesting, what probably many of you have no idea, Intel was in the game even back then. However, it was far behind Motorola in terms of CPU design and performance. As industry progressed, it became obvious that Apple will have to make the switch. You see, in early 90s, there were a lot of problems with Motorola. They weren't able to deliver their chips, overheating issues. In the meanwhile, Microsoft and Intel started taking over the world. During that time, Apple has been considering other alternatives and chip designs. That started even in late 80s. Research group at Apple, ATG or Advanced Technology Group, was in charge of various research activities. One of them was a very highly confidential project called Aquarius, where Apple tested new multi-core design referred as Scorpius. Apple apparently developed experimental quad-core CPU called Antares, which was way before the term multi-core processors came to life. Anyway, in 1991, Apple, IBM, and Motorola have formed AIM Alliance as a response to potential Microsoft and Intel duopoly. They have introduced new Power PC architecture to the market. Apple Power Macintosh from 1994 was the first Apple computer with Power PC processor. Other devices followed, and the first CPU architecture switch was completed. A couple of years after, AIM Alliance collapsed, and Apple was also failing to reach 3 GHz clock speed. That meant preparations for the next big change. On WWDC in 2005, Steve Jobs announced plans to move to Intel. In just a few months afterwards, the first Apple computers with Intel CPU came to the market. Obviously, transition from PowerPC to Intel wasn't that smooth and silky, especially since there were many pro apps designed specifically for PowerPC architecture. You may or you may not know this, but Apple did consider using AMD CPU in 2011. There was an interest in producing a MacBook Air models with AMD APU chips called Jano. But that did not happen. There were doubts that AMD could not fulfill supply demand. In 2010, Apple launched their own A14 chip. It powered the first iPad, iPhone 4, and it was powerful and efficient. Now, in 2011, Apple invested around $4 billion in something described as long-term components contracts. This initiated speculations about potential revival of Aquarius project. Web portal SemiAccurate made an article with very interesting headline in the same year, predicting Apple's departure from Intel. Fast forward, not long after Apple's announcement of very powerful lineups of A-series processors, till A13 Bionic, which now dominates mobile CPU market, it was obvious that Apple can accomplish something more. The crown of those designs were improved chips used to power special iPad lines of devices developed with professionals in mind. Apple's A12X or A12Z Bionic, for example, according to benchmarks, were faster than top-of-the-line Intel Core i7 CPUs from top-tier 2015 MacBook Pro. Recently, unofficial performance results are showing that the upcoming A14 Bionic is the first ARM processor capable of crossing 3 GHz clock speed. The same A14 chip, according to Bloomberg, will be the CPU of choice for the first ARM-powered Apple notebooks. It is estimated that the initial ARM model MacBook will come with Apple's 5-nanometer 12-core chip. This processor will have 8 high-performance cores called Firestorm and 4 efficient ones codenamed iStorm. Reports suggest that other MacBooks are in plan as well, with performance improvements and more cores. This process will once again happen gradually, and without a doubt, it will have the biggest impact on developers and professionals that rely on specific types of apps. Now, in 2020, on the upcoming Worldwide Developers Conference, Apple is about to announce the next chapter. Intel's failure to deliver chips on time, slow improvements in terms of speed and power efficiency, comparable to their main competitor AMD, and many security flaws, gave sufficient reason to Apple to definitely move away from Intel. Published lines of macOS beta started wave of predictions that Apple might ditch Intel for AMD. Personally, I don't believe that's gonna happen anytime soon. Top-of-the-line MacBooks with Intel CPU are still a great option until Apple is ready to implement its in-house built chips to higher-end notebooks. Intel will serve just fine. Nevertheless, having code ready for AMD as a backup shouldn't confuse anyone. Plus, seems like newly leaked information about the announcement of redesigned iMac with appearance similar to iPad Pro with small bezels can surprise us with AMD's Navi GPU. This fits perfectly in line with leaked code. We will have to wait for June 22. And what's your take on this story? Apple MacBooks transition to ARM architecture? What are your expectations? Please share in the comments below. If you like this video, hit the thumbs up. And once again, don't forget to subscribe. Thank you for watching Digital Markings. Talk to you soon. Have an excellent day. Bye.